Hey everybody, we are playing Gears 5. I almost said Gears of War 5, but that is not the name anymore.
No, it's just Gears 5.
Yeah, Gears 5, and we've jumped into Act 2, not even the start of Act 2. We're like, I don't know, 6-7 hours into the game, maybe.
And already we're in a snowy land.
Yeah, this is the first major hub world, so... Adam, I don't know how much you know about Gears 5, but Gears 5 has gone open world.
I don't know much about Gears 5, but I did play all the other ones, so...
Yeah, so the other ones are not open world, as you might remember.
It's just a point A to point B kind of stuff.
Yeah, so this one has these big hub worlds that you have to go through.
And that's where we are at now?
Yeah, for most of the game, actually. So there's four acts. Act one is traditional Gears, straight ahead sort of thing. And then act two and three are these giant hubs. There's this one, which is a snowy one. There's a desert in act three. And then act four is like a quick wrap up at the end.
So is there actual things to find in the environment, like if you take the time to explore?
Pretty much not.
Oh, great.
So this is sort of my thing, is it's very much a, like, Gears doing open world for the first time. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, they tell you pretty much, especially Act 2, there's like a radar that they shoehorn into this game that just, like, reveals every spot that you could possibly go to. There are a couple of like guns and stuff. Like if you want a rare weapon, they have scattered a few of those around. But for the most part, it's pretty much you just go to the place you're supposed to go. But it does look very pretty.
It does. It looks really nice running on this 1080 Ti.
I don't know. You've played all the Gears games, correct?
Yes, I have.
So this is Mount Kadar, which you might remember from Gears 2. It's the mountain that they built a secret lab under that Marcus discovers.
Wow. Okay.
So you come back to Mount Kadar for Gears 5. There are some callbacks to that story. I won't spoil too much about it, but you do find a secret lab again.
Labs. My favorite.
That's kind of what we're here to do right now. We also have this robot, Jack. I don't think that you can see the upgrade tree, but if on my end, if I hit tab, Jack has like an upgrade tree that he gets more abilities over the course of the game.
It says the upgrade tree that I have has two options already unlocked.
Yep. Cool.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, like a shock trap and a stim.
Yep.
A pulse and a flash. So yeah, over the course of the game, you get these components that you can upgrade those with. I used the flash, and later on you get a cloaking ability. They're both super overpowered. I think the flash was like when you flash people after you unlock a thing during this act two, that it freezes whoever you flash. How about you drive? I'll jump in the nav.
Okay.
It's left mouse to move forward and right mouse to stop.
How do I get on it?
With E.
It's not giving me the prompt.
Maybe it just hates you.
Yeah. Weird.
Maybe.
Also, I should say that I have literally... This is the first time I'm touching this game. Maybe it's because I had that...
Gun. So you can store that gun on the front of our little skiff here.
There we go. Now I've got it. All right. But yeah, this is the first time I am touching this game. So
yeah, I should say I finished this game already, but Adam just installed it today so we could do some co-op stuff.
Yeah, and co-op is always my favorite part of Gears, to tell you the truth.
He's also trying to hang with a mouse and keyboard, which is not Adam's style.
No, it's not. Usually I do the controller, especially on Gears.
So yeah, there's a big gate up ahead that we can't get through yet.
Okay.
We're eventually going to turn up. You'll notice there's like a compass up on the top.
Uh-huh.
We're going to go
back. So don't go this way?
We just can't get through there yet.
Oh, okay.
So if you turn to the left,
Oh, I see.
I marked like a waypoint along the way. Got and then it. We're going to go past that and go up to, there's a mission eventually. So yeah, this is the open world, and like, it's just very, like, this is the only, one of the only structures, this little like shack here, that's not tied to a mission. Most of them, weird. Okay, go to the left real quick.
Oh, okay.
See this like yellow flag?
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's like every, oh, and apparently when I'm playing co-op, I can like mark these things. Yeah, so these are like side missions, and they're all just like this. They're all marked.
Huh.
So you can like, we can get out and do a train tunnel, or you can just go to the main mission. But like every single location is like that. They're all, hey, here's a mission. It's, there's like nothing else in this open world.
And nothing to really explore. There's kind of not a lot of mystery
it's just
to it.
Like,
huh?
Yeah, it's just like, okay, here are the 12 things you need to do here.
Well, I want to shoot some horde. That's what I'm excited for.
There is no horde. They're the swarm.
What?
Yeah, I can't. So you played Gears 4?
Yeah.
Yeah, so if you'll remember, the locusts don't exist anymore.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
Yeah, the swarm, which look identical to locusts.
I almost mixed those up. I totally forgotten.
Yeah, it still makes me laugh that they were like, oh, it's a different thing. They're not locusts this time. But yeah, same collectibles. Oh, interesting. When you pick up a collectible, it opens for me too. And then, yeah, those yellow things, those are the components that you upgrade Jack with.
Oh, interesting. Okay.
So you just kind of find those around. There are some, like, repair panels that you find them in. Some of them are just hidden in the environment. And so, yeah, over time, like, you get to a point where Jack's flash ability, at first it just, like, stuns enemies.
Mm-hmm.
You eventually get to a point where it literally freezes them in place. And then they take, like, the enemies take extra damage. So you can kill some of the bigger enemies in the game without ever getting close to them.
Interesting.
Just freeze them and shoot them a bunch. And then the cloak ability lets you stealth kill, which is a weird thing for Gears.
Yeah, right? Stealth killing is not what a big,
that's
burly
like a,
man
that's
usually
like a,
does.
Hey, you'd kill like one guy, right? And then move on.
Yeah.
But no, I've had, in this game, I've cleared out like entire rooms of enemies.
No way, that seems weird. That seems weird for Gears.
Yeah, it's super overpowered. Huh. But yeah, they're trying some stuff. Like, that's the thing that I'll say about Gears 4, or sorry, Gears 5, is that it feels like them actually trying to do something interesting. Mm-hmm. I feel like Gears 4 was very much just like, hey, why does this game exist? It's pretty much just Gears again. I think Gears 5, it's not perfect. In fact, it's like a lot of it is just kind of generic still, or like the open world stuff, it's like kind of half busted.
Yeah.
But I at least am like, hey, good on you for not just making the same Gears game for the 12th time.
Yeah, right. Also, I do want to mention good on them for having an amazing PC port, right?
Yeah, it's real good.
Like, yeah, I'm going to stop for a second and show people the options menu.
Oh, yeah.
All these video options are just, like, crazy. And not only can you go through each one of them step by step, you can also hit spacebar to see, like, a little preview of like how the different things, the attributes affect the visual quality, and the built-in benchmark is also really nice as well. I have been very happy messing around with the benchmark already a couple times.
Yeah, all of the different, like, hey, this is an impact on CPU, this is an impact on GPU. I always like when they do that stuff.
Yeah,
it makes it easier to track down like what's actually having.
And it makes them feel like they're paying special attention to the PC, which is nice.
Yeah.
Oh, boom shot. Boom.
I will say it's still very much a, it's that Gears art style, which feels pretty cartoony to me.
Yeah.
Especially like that Gears 4 art style. They did that like, hey, it's going to be very colorful, which I like more than the like desaturated look of the originals.
Uh-huh.
But also, it still looks kind of cartoony to me.
I do have to ask, are there any Gears bobbleheads?
No.
Okay.
I don't think so.
Well, that's good.
Yeah, there are no Gears Funko Pops.
Yeah. Oh, now I gotta It's teamwork, right?
Oh, yeah.
And I have to be in this very specific spot to hit E.
Oh, there we go.
There we go. Come on up.
Yeah, some of this stuff is a lot easier when you're by yourself.
Oh, I can imagine.
Yeah. Dell just automatically does what he's supposed to. So yeah, we have this crazy ice storm that we're running through. These big pillars falling out of the sky. It's super impressive. I like the... Also, like, I don't love the art style in terms of how cartoony it looks, but I love like how impressive some of these effects are.
Yeah, and performance so far on this this 1080 Ti machine has been pretty good. I'm at 1080p with everything maxed out and getting about 130 right now. What about...
You on 144 there?
No. Oh, and I am already down. I forgot you got to take cover in this.
Crawl towards me, buddy.
You gotta help me up!
Oh, jeez.
Oh, no. Oh, right. No. There we go. Thank you. Whoops.
So I just used the stim ability, which gives us extra armor.
Oh, okay.
So that was how I got out to you.
Stay down. Oh, goodness. Goodness gracious. Wow. It's I'm a little rusty. I'm a horrible teammate right now.
That's okay. That's why I'm here to carry you, usual.
Thank you. It's about time. But yeah, you're on a 2080 Ti at home.
Yeah, 2080 Ti.
It's running pretty well.
Yeah, it's been rock solid. Mm-hmm. There's there's no nothing that would really give this trouble, I don't think. There's no ray tracing or anything like that in this port. So it still looks pretty damn good.
Roger that. Yeah, a tentpole release for Microsoft.
Yeah, the first in a while.
Yeah.
I'm trying to think of what
Forza Horizon was pretty fun.
Yeah, but that was last year. Trying to think what else was in 2019, and honestly, I can't think of anything.
It had to have been something.
There's no Forza this year, so
yeah.
That automatically takes away half their games.
Marcus, found your hallway and your circular door. Looks like somebody blew it up.
So yeah, this is the facility that Marcus came to in Gears 2.
Huh.
So what now?
Dang. I almost feel like I need to replay those again. It's been a while.
Yeah, it was pretty surprising to have a bunch of callbacks to Gears 2. Because I feel like Gears 4 was very much... They tried to get away from original Gears stuff. And this one feels more like, okay, maybe there was some stuff worth revisiting from that original trilogy. So we're going to fight a warden here. They're like these big dudes with armor heads.
I'm going to keep my distance.
Yeah, that's probably a good call.
Is there a weak spot?
You have to shoot him in the head. I knocked the helmet off already. So yeah, that's the flash ability that I just used. So now he's stunned. I can just play into him.
Wait, so since you're replaying this level, do you have any like upgrades that you're carrying over?
I don't, but I think that's because I started a new game. I think if I went back on my real save file and did that, it would be fine. But I started a new game just so I wouldn't screw up my progress over there.
Oh, got it. That makes sense.
Ammo. Oh, our ammo is shared.
Is it really?
You stole my ammo crate.
Oh, I'm sorry about that.
I did not realize because again, played this whole thing solo. So, can't remember one of these we go through.
I also mentioned we're playing on the Microsoft or the Windows Store.
We should talk
Microsoft
about the
Microsoft Store, I think.
Steam version of this now.
Yeah, right? If we wouldn't have been playing it here, I definitely would have been playing it on Steam.
So yeah, these safes, they are another way that you can find the components for Jack, so we'll get free here.
Nice.
And that should be enough. If you actually pull up that upgrade menu, you should be able to upgrade some of the stuff in there.
Huh. Nice.
So yeah, it's a kind of neat system. The ultimate upgrades are the ones that are locked at the end. They have like a yellow tint.
Mm-hmm.
And those are the ones that you get through, like, completing side missions and stuff. And they're also more interesting than the normal upgrades. So, like, they make your shock traps chase enemies. They're the ones that freeze the people in place when you flash them.
Mm-hmm.
There's the one for the cloaking ability is you... we got juvies. The one for the cloaking ability is you can shoot while cloaked still, which comes in super handy.
This kind of has some crazy kickback.
What are you using?
I don't know, some sort of SMG kind of thing. And my active reload skills on mouse and keyboard are not as good as controller.
My bigger problem is on a TV, I feel like that active reload bar is always in the corner of your vision. But on a monitor, it's a little bit out of the way. It's like tucked up in that top right corner.
Well, back in the day, I definitely got used to not even looking.
Yeah, you definitely get there eventually. I think we go through this door. So yeah, I'm enjoying it. Or I enjoyed it, I should say. Definitely more than Gears 4, which I felt was a I don't know.
Not good. I can tell you that.
Workmanlike, I guess, is a good descriptor.
Yeah.
It just existed and it was fine. I feel like this one definitely has more going for it. Oh, you can stealth kill him. If you walk up behind him and hit F.
Oh, okay. Well, whoop, and then he went flying.
Well, so yeah, we've got a couple of those corrupted robots in here that we can stealth kill, but eventually we'll probably have to just go for it.
Yeah, stealth just feels so weird in this game.
Well, you didn't have much of it, so.
Man.
Yeah, I'm enjoying it. It's definitely more of a more interesting to me than Gears 4 was. But I still kind of just feel like this. I don't know. I feel like Gears and Halo both have the same problem, which is they feel very much of an era
of the past.
Yeah, like I feel like both of those games or both those series might have been better off just left behind on the 360 era. Do you know what I mean?
Oh, no, I'm down. I do have to say I am excited for Master Chief, the Halo Master Chief Collection coming out on PC.
Oh, same.
Yeah.
And I'm curious to see what they do with Infinite. Like, the same thing as Gears 5. It feels like them trying to do something new with that series. I feel like it's hard to reinvent a series like Gears or Halo. Like, those are both series with a very definite... identity to them, and the idea of like, oh, we'll just like change how Gears plays, like we'll add open world sections to Gears, like that seems very strange to me.
Oh man, something was hitting me. Whoa,
you're stuck in the gas.
Oh no,
you died.
I died, dang it.
Well, standard playing with Adam.
Yep.
And yeah, so you have to use that that T, the like stim ability.
Okay. Man, I wondered why that knocked on. Oh, and the physics is just hilarious. Some old school video game physics right there.
Throw a frag down there.
So how long did it take you to beat it, do you think?
Oh, I would say 15-ish hours, maybe. Okay. It felt like standard Gears length.
Okay. And I'm not even going to ask you, because this is obviously a full-price game.
Yes, this is the... for once.
Yeah. This is a tentpole release, so there's no question about how many dollars you're going to be spending on this.
Yeah, as we said, like the main thing that's interesting here is the first Microsoft game to come to Steam in, 10, not 10 years, but close. This whole console generation, basically. So, that's exciting. I'm kind of sad that the games that were in between will probably never come to Steam. Oh, like all the Forza Horizons that have come out in the last, you know.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
5 years, 6 years, whatever. Similar to, like, they started doing the, you know, they started doing the Xbox Play Anywhere stuff. After, like, that was like 2 or 3 years into the Xbox One life cycle. So there's a lot of Xbox One games from the early days of that console that I'll just never have on PC. Forza Horizon 2, Rare Replay Collection.
Oh.
So yeah, we gotta take out this flock.
That is impressive looking. Reminds me of something out of Evil Within 2.
Ooh, I'm getting... Yeah, I think they showed flocks in the old games, but never that up close, I don't think, and never that many of them. That was like, I think in like the first Gears, you end up killing those things, right? While you're in the truck.
Oh, really? Wow, okay, I didn't even realize that was the same thing.
I think it's the updated Swarm version of it instead of the Locust version, but yeah, I'm pretty sure it's the same concept. It's been a while since I played Gears, but you know. The main thing that I found funny is they start this game off with a previously on.
Oh!
Previously on Gears 4. And I realized that I did not remember anything about that game.
Yeah, that's probably the same for me.
It was kind of eye-opening how little I remembered about that game. You got it. You know,
I'd really like to find this letter. I mean, that's all the Gears games in general, to tell you the truth.
Yeah, I think
except
this
for
one,
when what's his name died.
See, that's the thing is, I remember like the major moments of a bunch of them. Gears 4, I realized I literally remembered nothing. It was just like I couldn't remember any of the plot elements, any of the characters even really. Like JD, who was the protagonist of the last game, Marcus's son, was just like the most boring guy. So it's nice playing as like Kate. Kate's a lot more interesting, and you're playing as Del, who's also, he was like the sidekick character last time. He's a lot more interesting than JD was. And JD is, you actually start the game playing as JD, and then they sort of leave him off to the side for the rest of the game, which is kind of nice.
Interesting.
I didn't really miss him. Wait, what? How is he still alive? He preserved himself as an AI construct. So yeah, Niles, who I don't know if you remember, he was like the AI dude from Gears 2, who you find in the lab.
Kinda.
He's the one that we're looking for in here, and I can't remember what places the maze, so somewhere in here.
Do we have a flashlight? What's the flashlight toggle?
We don't. It's Jack here, and I guess Jack follows me and just leaves you completely blind.
Yeah, pretty much.
It's interesting. Yeah, because he follows me and he like basically acts like my flashlight, but
This is kind of a dark area.
Yeah, I don't know where. Oh, it's gotta be. Yeah, there we go. All right.
Oh, okay. I didn't even notice there was a hallway down that way.
Yeah, me neither. Looks like creepy kids room.
Oh, good. That's a good creepy kids room.
Gotta go through the window. This
is disgusting. What kind of kid draws that?
You know, the kind of kid who turns into a locust queen, maybe.
Oh, the locust queen.
something to do with the locust. It has something to do with you. They still climb ladders one-handed. You know, it's a Gears game.
Yeah. It's tough. You can't just put your gun down. Marcus. Gotta be ready to shoot at any moment.
Yeah, I think we're coming up on the end of this. It's not really the end of the level, but end of this little sub-level here. And that might be a good place to call it.
All right, sounds good to me.
So you're gonna play through this?
Yeah, I'm mildly excited to try it out. I have pretty much done everything I could in Control, so I need something else to do. Oh, man. Yeah, game of the year so far for me.
Yeah, nice.
Easy. And I think I'll enjoy this.
Yeah, it's
a good
like
summer blockbuster kind of.
Well, that's
popcorn
the thing. I almost
vibe.
Feel like Gears 4 kind of, Gears 5 kind of screwed itself by coming out so close to Control, because Control has like a very similar, not like super similar, but kind of similar third-person shootery vibe to it. And I played that and was like blown away by like how creative it was. And then I played Gears 5 and I was like, but yeah, it's definitely a Gears game.
Yeah, been here. It's like a comfortable blanket, you know.
Yep.
You just tuck into on a hot summer night. I don't know why you would put a hot blanket on.
Yeah, I'll put a blanket on in the hot summer, but yeah.
Why not?
Yeah, here's Niles. As I said, he's the guy who this like whole lab area is. One of the climactic battles in Gears 2. I don't know if you remember, but it's like this underground lab, and there was like a central corridor with two little corridors off to the side, and you kind of fought your way out of it. Niles is still here, but kind of a shadow of himself.
Hmm. Interesting.
And I will say that I think that this game picks up a lot in the back half. I thought Act 1 was pretty boring. Act 2 was better, but the open world stuff is sort of clumsy. And then Act 3, you go to I haven't played Judgment, but a part of the world that I didn't really know anything about in terms of Gears lore.
Mm-hmm.
And there's like a much different art style to it. It's very neat. And then from there, it sort of just turns into like an all-out, like, run to the end sort of scenario.
Mm-hmm.
I think if you're fair with it, I think Acts 3 and 4 do a lot of interesting stuff. That's Gears 5, I guess. It is it's Gears. I feel like that's always like very diminutive, but like that really feels like the case here. Like it's definitely a Gears game.
Nice. Well, thanks for taking some time to play with me.
We're going to roadie run our way out of here. That's a good place to end.
Yeah, roadie run's my favorite. You just run. Who knows if we'll ever make it out, because I'm probably going to stop the recording sometime now.